Hello guys, how you all doing? Trust you are doing so wonderful. Today we want to see how to design this music art cover design using your Pixel Lab application. This tutorial was requested for by one of our subscribers, Richmond. Shout out to you, Richmond, and please feel free to drop your comment telling us where you are watching from and which tutorial you would love us to work on next. We'll kindly deliver it to you. If you are coming across our page for the first time, don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell so that you are informed whenever we bring awesome content like this. So today I'll be showing you how to design this, and later on I'll also expose you to a secret app that you will use to add a Photoshop light effect on your design, how you can make it look like this. Awesome, right? I guess so. So I will be showing you how to put on this light on your design, this lens flare on your design that gives your design so much beauty. Please don't go away, as this tutorial is just going to be wonderful. If you are coming across our channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe, and we say much thanks to all our returning subscribers. Thank you guys for the love and support. So without wasting much of your time, let's get to work. So I'm going to launch my Pixel Lab application, and this is the default page. Normally the application looks this way. So what am I going to do? I'm going to start preparing the background. Okay, so just kindly follow me, and I will say here that guys, all the resources I will be using for this design, please kindly check the description of this video. I will leave the link on how you can get it there. So I'm going to delete this text and start working on my background. So the first thing I'm going to do is to click on the background setting, and after clicking on the background setting, I will click from gallery. So we are going to import our background from our photo gallery, and this is the background. Once you have that, just click on the 1:1 size down here in order to make your design a square size. Kindly position the square size this way, click on the check mark, and you have your background. Up next, I would love you to click on this middle button, click on the middle button, then click on import, and let's import this other blurred yellow background. Okay, so you can search for blurred yellow backgrounds on Google, on Pinterest, and you have these kind of resources. So I'm going to just spread it to cover the entire design space, and after spreading it, go to relative position to make sure that it's well aligned to the middle by using these two buttons. Once you are happy with that, click on the check mark and come to opacity, reduce the opacity to about 65, click the check mark to continue. So after clicking on the check mark, go to layer button and lock it up. Then we are going to bring in another background, another stage light effect background that I actually arranged on my PixArt application. As you can see, I'm just going to crop it this way in order to make it fitted to the design. So I'm going to space this out. Don't panic for these resources. I will leave the link on how to get them on the description. Please don't forget to check them out. And as you watch the tutorial, please subscribe, share it with your friends. So after placing this element like this, I'm just going to click to back. Good. So it has given it that awesome stage light effect, as you can see here. This is what we wanted. So remember, this is a music art cover design, so you need to bring elements that communicate music or some form of entertainment. I'm going to click now on the layer button, then I click on the lock button to lock everything up. Up next, I would love to bring in the image of the artist, and we're doing this design for Minister Gook. I don't know whether most of you know Minister Gook, but he's one of my favorite guys. He's one of my favorite Nigerian gospel artists. So we're doing this design for him. So I just want to bring the image to focus. And after bringing the image to focus, I would love to use relative position to tack it to the middle. Click on the layer button to lock it up. After doing that, click on the text element. So let's try to bring the image down a little, okay, so that it fits well properly. So we're going to bring the image down a little. Good. Then you can click on text, click on text to bring in the first text. So the first text we want to write here is the name of the artist, and he's usually called Minister Gook. Minister Gook here, this Gook, I search online and I'm seeing that it stands for Gift Ogochukwu Kingsley. That's by the way though. So I'm just going to click OK. Then we can't leave that this text on a white color because that background there has a lot of light. So in order to maintain the principle of reversibility, we are going to bring in a color that is somehow dark. So I'm going to click on the plus button here to set the color. Once you click on the plus button, click on the color picker option, then you can, we are going to sample the color from the artist. So just click on the layer hosting the artist. Then we can bring the color picker option to somewhere where we can find a dark color. So as you are selecting the color, please always check up here. The color monitor is there to tell you the color that you have currently chosen. I'm going forward to click OK, and I click on the check mark. Now come to fonts, and the font we want to use for this is a bold font, a font that is stylistic but bold. So the name of the font is E-Square Demo. Please download E-Square Demo on the font. And if you are still facing difficulties on how to download font, I'm going to leave a tutorial that I made earlier. I'm going to leave the link to the tutorial on the video description. Also go and watch it out and find out your, sort yourself out on how to download fonts. So I'm going to click OK now. Then I'm going to reduce the size of the text a little. After reducing the size, go to spacing and space it out well. So I'm still going to space this out. Go to spacing, space it to about 60, then click on the check mark. You can use your relative position now to place it on the middle. So I have Minister Gook. Make sure that everything looks so nice. Then after placing it this way, what you need to do next is to click on this middle button to bring in a shape. So we are going to click on shapes. Click on shapes. As you click on shape, convert this square shape to a rectangle by designing it this way. Then you can click on the color option down here. Click on gradient to choose a gradient color. So we're going to click now on plus to set the gradient. So please pay attention here. Now a gradient is a combination of two or more colors. That's why we have a white color, then we have a black color. But then we want to edit out the white color, we want to edit the white color. And how can we do that? By clicking here and also here. So let's go tap tap. Then what we're going to do here is to reduce the opacity of this white completely. So we're going to pull this to the left margin, then you click OK. Also click OK and click on the check mark to proceed. And as you can see, boom, our gradient or blurred effect is created. Is this not awesome? Please subscribe to the channel for more interesting content, for we share regular design tutorials and tips here every 48 hours. Thank you so much as you do so. Now we're going to click on color to change the color of the gradient or the fading effect that we have just created. We are going to change the color into something more proper. Now I would love you to click on this plus button, and after clicking on the plus button, click on this color picker to select. So we're going to select the color from the background, and after selecting a color from the background, click on the check mark up here to proceed. Click OK once again, and we have a nice color for our gradient. Just place the gradient this way nicely, then copy it in order to make it more visible. Use relative position to tag everything to the middle. Then you can go to layer and lock everything up. Once you lock them up, go to text and write. So it's Consuming Fire. The name of the song is Consuming Fire, but then we just want to write Consuming first. Then we go to font. Want to use a particular font here called the Christmas Wish Calligraphy Regular. So download the Christmas Wish Calligraphy Regular font on the font as well. So I'm going to click OK. increase the size. And as you can see, there are some problems of paddling here, as the edge of the sea is not showing completely. So how can you adjust that? Simply double tap on the text, then go to the beginning and give it a spacing, some spacing, in order to allow the sea breathe out well. Can you see that? Awesome. Now we're going to expand it more, since it is the main element or the main typography of the design. We're going to make it more visible for hierarchy's sake. After doing that, click on the relative position tool to tack it to the middle. You can even bring it down a little, then you go to layer and lock it up. Once you are satisfied with it, I would love you to click on this Minister Gook. So we're going to copy it, double tap, to write fire. So the full title of the song is Consuming Fire. I don't know if you have listened to this song, but hey guys, it is so awesome. Try listening to it, you won't be left the same. So I'm going to go to spacing now. On spacing, I'm going to reduce the spacing completely, undo the spacing to zero, then I'm going to use position now to align this text properly. So it's consuming fire, consuming fire. So this is the title of the song, as you can all see. Now we want to bring in the production house, the name of the production house. So we are going to copy this text, just write produced by. So we're just going to write pro by, okay, and it should be in capital letters. Now you can reduce the size considerably. I think 25 is okay for that. Then use your position tool to bring it down here. Good. Now this song is produced by Exclusive Gospel Concept. So we're just going to write Exclusive Gospel. So let's go to text, double tap, to write Exclusive Gospel. It should be in capital letters. But then go to color and give it the same dark color that we extracted from the gospel artist. Then go to your font and give it the Bebas font. We want to use Bebas regular for this. So as you can see, now we have Exclusive Gospel. You can reduce the size a little in order to make it fit well on that space. Exclusive Gospel. So we are trying to align everything properly. So produced by Exclusive Gospel. Good. So with this, guys, we are done with designing our music art cover. And as I promised, I'm going to now take you to another application where you add the lens flare to make the design pop up. So please continue watching. But before you go, endeavor to save your design. So we are going to save this design. Save your design nicely into your photo gallery. So we are going to save it. Please don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notification bell so that you are not left out when awesome contents like this are passing by. So we, after saving the design, we are going to go now to this application called PSCC Touch. Okay, this is a Photoshop clone application specifically for mobiles. So what I'm going to do now is to click on this plus button to create a project. So I'm also going to leave the link to get this application on the video description. Just check it out, download and install on your mobile. After doing this, I'm going to click now on photo library. Then I go to my photo library on Pixel Lab, and I'm going to search around to get this, where we have our music art cover. So before you do this, make sure that you have downloaded the lens flare. The lens flare, you can download it from Pinterest. Just search for lens flare online on Google and you have it. So after bringing in the design to the PSCC Touch, all you need to do now is to click here to add a folder. So we're going to click here and you click on this plus button, then you take photo layer, take again photo library. So click photo library, then we're going to click on this back button to search for where we want it. So I want to get this from my pins. It's from Pinterest. So this is the lens flare that I want us to add. All I'm going to do is just to click on it, then I click add, and as you can see, it has been added. Further, click down here on this check mark to proceed. So just click on the check mark, and once you are done clicking on the check mark, I would love you to click up here first of all. So as you click up here, sorry about that, so let's undo that. I would love you to click here rather. So just click here on this FX, then you click on this first option, this blur option. We want to blur the edges of the lens flare. Then you can increase this, and as you can see, the edges are well blurred. After doing that, just click on this check mark, and I would love you now to click on this same layer button. And as you click on the layer button, you should click here now on this layer panel, then you click here again on this touchdown button, then you click blend, you tick on screen, and as you can see, we have our lens flare now created. So what can you do, how can you do now to move this lens flare to the position that you want? Just click on this other button, then you click on transform to move the lens flare. So we just want to position the lens flare here. Then we're even going to increase it in size to make it more visible and realistic. Awesome, great. So we are satisfied with that, and all we need to do now is to click on the check mark, then click done. Click on done. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss awesome contents like this. So I'm now going to click on save. I want to show you now how you can save your work after editing it. So I have this now. So I'm just going to click on this share. Click on share, then save to gallery. Click save to gallery and select the design. So it's this last one. I'm just going to click on it, then I take on OK down here on OK, then it's saved to my gallery. Now you can go to your gallery and check it out. So let's check. Awesome, so this is the design. All right, good. So with this, guys, let's call it a wrap on how you can design and add a lens flare to your music art cover using your Pixel Lab application and the PSCC Touch application. I believe we all learned one or two things. Thanks so much for your support, our returning subscribers. And please, if you are coming to our channel for the first time, hit that subscribe button right now. Turn on the notification bell so that you're not left out when awesome contents like this are released. We really appreciate the love. Thanks so much. Let us know where you are watching from and which tutorial you would love us to do next. Subscribe now. God bless you.